Parvati is a widowed person living with HIV and lives with her 12-year-old daughter in a rented house in Bangalore, India. She struggles to make ends meet and wishes there was more support. Although there are more than 150 government social protection schemes in India, these are not easily within reach of PL-HIV, women in sex work, men who have sex with men, transgenders, and people who inject drugs. The DAPQ-led single window model, piloted by Department of AIDS Control, UNDP and Swasthi, has emerged as an effective way to leverage the existing infrastructure and staff of HIV prevention and impact mitigation programs for facilitating social protection of affected communities. Let's look at how this model works. Parvati wants to apply for a housing scheme and goes to the social protection help desk within the PL-HIV district network. Parvati receives help to fill out the application. The help desk then aggregates the applications and submits them to the social protection officer at the DAPQ. The social protection officer reviews the applications and submits them to the relevant government departments with a cover letter from the DAPQ officer. The receiving department, housing in the case of Parvati, reviews the file, notes the recommendation from DAPQ and processes it. The social protection officer follows up with the department till Parvati receives the benefit.
I now have a home, a permanent address, through the Rajiv Gandhi housing scheme. I no longer pay rent and use the money saved to send my child to school. I also have a garland making business and motivate other people living with HIV to apply for social protection schemes.
Scaling up of the DAPQ-led single window model will increase access to and uptake of social protection for key population groups and improve the quality of their lives.